come, I confess that when here I find my rest. Without you I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh,
grace and peace to you from God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Here we are, another Wednesday. The countdown has begun to the end of the semester, and we pray for God's presence and guidance in your lives as you navigate the waters of the last few weeks of classes. Our opening scripture reading today is from Hebrews chapter 4. I'll begin reading at verse 9 and end with the 12th verse. I invite you to listen for God's word as you follow along on the screen. There remains then a Sabbath rest for the people of God. For anyone who enters God's rest also rests from their works, just as God did from his. Let us therefore make every effort to enter that rest so that no one will perish by following the example of disobedience. For the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow. It judges the thoughts and attitudes of the heart. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please join me in our opening prayer. Heavenly Father, as we pause in the midst of this week, the middle of the week, we ask for your blessings. We ask for your guiding hand to be at work in our lives. We pray that you will lift us from all that overwhelms us at this point, allowing us to relax and to forget it all and to come to you in prayer. We pray, Lord, that you would hear us as we pray for one another, for our student body, our faculty, and our staff. May you continue to guide us in the work that we do. In your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Himself known and show us the way back to him, speaking wisdom and truth into the hearts of peasants and kings. He began to unveil the word that would change the course of all things. With eyes wide return. Lord, let your word fall on us.
physicians, tax collectors, farmers, fishermen, singers, and shepherds. The marvel is that a library so perfectly cohesive could have been produced by such a diverse crowd over a period of time which staggers the imagination. Jesus is his grand subject. Our good is designed, and the glory of God is its end.
The word is alive, and it cuts like a sword through the darkness with a message of life.
Scripture readings today come from Philippians chapter 2, verse 5, and Romans chapter 15, verse 5. Listen for God's word. In your relationships with one another, have the same mind as Christ Jesus. And then Romans, may the God who gives endurance and encouragement give you the same attitude of mind toward each other that Christ Jesus had. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Ability, motivation, and attitude. Ability is what you're capable of doing. Each and every person who is part of the college community has been given the ability to succeed, both in the classroom, in the concert hall, on the court, on the field of play. Ability to communicate with one another, ability to love one another, ability to be the best person you can be. But it comes down to motivation. What is it that motivates you to succeed? What motivates you to go into the class every day and study on your free time, or go into the weight room and prepare for a field of battle when you get out on the lacrosse field, or to go into the practice room and play the organ or play the trumpet so that you're prepared when it's time for you to prepare and deliver your recital? Motivation. What gets you out of bed every day? What causes you to be a nice person? What causes you to deal with challenges in a good and positive way? All of it now comes down to attitude. You've got ability, you've got motivation, but now, what's your attitude like? How do you respond? Do you surround yourself with negative people? Because if you do, then you become negative. But if you surround yourself with positive people, then you become a positive person yourself. I choose positive as opposed to negative. Attitude is what keeps me going. Attitude is what gets me out of bed, ready to take on the day and know that the Lord has blessed me with one more opportunity to be the best person God has created me to be. Attitude is what helps me sit down and study the scriptures on a daily basis, or spend time in prayer and reflection, or get up and take walks with our dog Macy, or to have good conversations with family and friends. Attitude takes you a long ways in life. Coming with the attitude is that ability to smile. To smile and be able to portray the person you are or the person you want to be. So God has given you all three. God's given you ability, God's given you motivation, and God gives you an attitude. May your attitude be Christ-like. May your attitude be filled with faith. May your attitude always be positive. May your attitude portray yourself as a Christian. May God bless you and keep you and make his face to shine upon you each day. Amen. Please join me in prayer. Eternal God, we praise you, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We praise you for your presence through the long march of our human history. We pray that you will speak to us again your gentle words, words of peace. Grant us your peace when our lives turn difficult and when we seem to be wandering and confused. Grant us your peace when we are vulnerable and frightened. Grant us your peace when we are walking through uncertain valleys and the next step seems only to hold foreboding for us. Grant us your peace when our health is threatened and when we feel fearful that our future may be limited or terminal. Grant us your peace when our sense of your presence is thin. Grant us your peace when our economic security is threatened and when our fears about tomorrow well up and overwhelm us. Grant us your peace when our questions and doubts seem stronger than our faith and trust, and give us courage to face them and to live them until we come again to a greater certainty. In all of life, may we hear again and again the words of Jesus, "Peace be with you." We ask your care for all who carry heavy burdens. Be with those who are sick, who are grieving. Be with the hungry, the poor. Grant them all your love and compassion. We ask this in your Son's holy name. Amen. Now go forth out into the world in peace. Rejoice in the power of God's Holy Spirit for you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord give you the gift of grace. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Won't forget every promise you have whispered to my